Hi guys, hope you are having a wonderful day. I'm Dorothea from Croby Patterns and I'm back with a new tutorial, this time for crochet baby cardigan. This tutorial is for newborn up to 6 months old babies and it's super easy to make. You can find the written instructions for this pattern on my blog and an inexpensive, beautifully designed PDF version of this pattern with two additional sizes in my Etsy shop. All the links are in the description box below. Now let me show you what you will need for this tutorial. You will need DK weight yarn in mustard yellow color or any color you like, DK weight yarn in olive white color if you want to have your cardigan in more than one color, or you can add additional colors of your choice. You will need 4mm or G6 crochet hook, stitch markers, yarn needle, and a pair of scissors. We will be working from the bottom to the top of the cardigan. Let's start with the main part. We will begin by making a foundation chain. We will start with a slip knot and you can create your slip knot whichever way you prefer. I will do that by crossing the yarn coming from the ball over the yarn end to form a circle. Then pull the yarn through the circle. You can do that with your crochet hook or your fingers as I'm doing here. We are going to start off by making our foundation chain. In crochet patterns, we call the wrapping yarn around the crochet hook yarn over. Wrap the yarn around the hook. Now pull the yarn through the loop on your hook. This is our first chain. Now create 73 chains in total. You can pause here and we can meet when you create all 73 chains. Now that you have 73 chains, long foundation chain, add two additional chains that will represent your turning chain. Now we will create our first double crochet stitch. You can also watch a full crochet lesson on how to make a double crochet stitch, how to join two stitches together with a double crochet two together stitch, and how to start a row of double crochet stitches that I posted earlier previous week. You can find the link to the video in the description box below. Let's start with our double crochet. Before you insert the hook into the loop, yarn over. Now insert the hook into the loop, yarn over again. Pull the yarn through the first two loops on your hook, yarn over again and pull the yarn through the remaining loops on your hook. We call this stitch double crochet stitch. Now create one double crochet stitch into each chain. At the end of this row, you should have 73 stitches. Pause the video here and work your way along the foundation chain and meet me back when you will be finishing your last stitch of this row. We are in the last stitch of our first row. Now we will change the yarn. If you would like to have your cardigan in one color only, skip this part. End your last stitch of this row and start with row 2. If you are changing colors, end your stitch before your last yarn over and pulling through the remaining stitches on your hook. With the white yarn, create a loop and pull it through. Chain 1 and turn your work. Create your first half double crochet stitch into the last stitch of the previous row. Yarn over and insert the hook into the loop. Yarn over and pull the loop through. Now you should have 3 loops on your hook. Yarn over again and pull the yarn through all 3 loops on your hook. And here you have it, your first half double crochet stitch. If you would like to watch more detailed video on half double crochet, you can find the link in the description box below. Work one half double crochet stitch into next 72 stitches. At the end of this row, you should have 73 stitches in total. So you can stop the video here and meet me back when you finish this row. If you are changing colors, stop before you start your last stitch of this row. I will show you how to change the yarn when you are crocheting half double crochet stitches. Now we will finish this row with our last half double crochet stitch and change the color. But before we do that, we have to cut the yarn on the other side of your work and secure the ends. I will do that by making a nice and tight double knot and hide the tails between the stitches later. But be careful and hide the white tail between the white stitches and the yellow one between the yellow stitches. Now let's get back where we left before. Unpin the marker and start working on your last stitch of this row. Yarn over, insert the hook, yarn over and pull the loop through. You have three loops on your hook. Take the yellow yarn and make a loop. Pull the loop through and chain two. Now turn the row and create your first double crochet into the last stitch of our previous row. Work one double crochet into next 72 stitches. At the end of this row, you should have 73 stitches. So what you will do next is you will repeat row 1 and 2, so the row of yellow double crochet stitches and row of white half double crochet stitches two more times. So at the end of this row, so row of yellow double crochet stitches, continue with a row of white half double crochet stitches, then continue with row of yellow double crochet stitches and with our last row of white half double crochet stitches. You can pause the video here and come back when you finish all 6 rows. We finished all 6 rows and it should look something like this. Row of yellow double crochet stitches and row of white half double crochet stitches 3 times, so together 6 rows. What you will do next is just continue working in rows using the yellow yarn to create 4 more rows of double crochet stitches. Each row has to have 73 double crochet stitches and at the beginning of each row make a chain 2 that represents your turning chain, then turn. Always create your first stitch of the row into the last stitch of the previous row. So let's do that, change the yarn, chain 2, work your first double crochet into the last stitch from the previous row, now work one double crochet into each stitch all the way to the end of the row. If you want, you can hide the yellow tail by crocheting a few first stitches around it and hide it between the stitches. Now you can pause the video here and make your 4 rows of double crochet stitches and meet me back when you will done. So here we are at the end of row 11. As you can see here, we have this zebra part where you were crocheting one row of yellow double crochet stitches and one row of white half double crochet stitches and 4 rows of yellow double crochet stitches. Next, you will place the marker into the 1st, 18th, 19th, 55th, 56th and last stitch of row 13. So if you fold your fabric on the parts marked with the markers, you will see the front left and right part of the cardigan and the large piece on the back is the back side of the cardigan. What we will do now is we will start where we left and create our first upper front part of our cardigan. Now insert the hook into the loop and chain 2. Create your first stitch of this row on the top of the last stitch from the previous one. Work one double crochet stitch into next 15 stitches. Join next 3 stitches with a double crochet 3 together stitch. And you have your first stitch on the hook. Now you have your second stitch on the hook. And this is your third stitch on the hook. Now pull the yarn through all three loops on your hook, and this is your double crochet, three together stitch. Chain two and turn the row. Join first two stitches with a double crochet, two together stitch. Place the marker. Work one double crochet into each of next 14 stitches. Now that we are done with our row 2 of our front upper part, let's start with row 3. Start with the chain 2. Work 1 double crochet into next 15 stitches. As you can see here, we finished our first three rows. Next two will be exactly the same as our row 3. So chain 2, add at the beginning of the row, then turn and create one double crochet into each stitch all the way to the end of the row. So 15 double crochet stitches all together. You can pause the video here and meet me back when you finish two rows of double crochet stitches. We are almost done with this part, two rows to go. We are in row 6 now, chain 2 and turn the row. Work 1 double crochet into next 7 stitches. Pause the video here and finish your stitches. Join next 3 stitches with a double crochet 3 together stitch. Let's continue with row 7, chain 1, turn the row and work 1 single crochet into next 8 stitches. Here we are at the end of our first front upper part of the cardigan. Now fasten off. Fasten off is a term in crochet to stop your work when it is complete. All you have to do is cut the yarn, yarn over, and pull the tail through the loop. You can leave a long tail for sewing. I somehow forgot that part and cut my ends too short, so I needed a separate strand of yarn to sew the top of the cardigan together. And here you have it, our first upper part is done, two parts to go, our back part and our upper front part that will be a mirror shape to the one we just created. We will start our back upper part here and we will continue working towards our undone upper front upper part of the cardigan. So insert the hook into the marked stitch, join the yarn, chain 2, I will crochet around the tail, join the next two stitches with a double crochet to together stitch, and if you look closely enough, you will see that we actually created a double crochet 3 together stitch because we joined 3 stitches together. We have a chain in the first stitch that we will skip in the next row, and double crochet 2 together stitch that is joining our next 2 stitches into 1 stitch. So technically, we join 3 stitches together into 1 stitch. Now continue working towards the next marker and create 1 double crochet stitch into next 31 stitches. As you did so many times before, you can stop the video here, finish your 31 double crochet stitches and meet me back when you are done. Now join next 3 stitches together with a double crochet 3 together stitch. Chain 2 and turn the row. Join the next 2 stitches with a double crochet 2 together stitch. Then work 1 double crochet stitch into next 29 stitches. If you want, you can pause here and meet me back when you finish all 29 stitches in this row. Now work double crochet 2 together stitch into your last 2 stitches. At the end of this row, you should have 31 stitches in total. Let's continue with our next row, so row 3. Next 3 rows, so row 3, 4 and 5 will be exactly the same. So chain 2 and then work 1 double crochet stitch into next 31 stitches. You can pause the video here and come back when you finish all 3 rows of double crochet stitches, so row 3, 4 and 5 of the upper back part of the cardigan. Now that you finished with rows of double crochet stitches, your work should look something like that. So you have to have 5 rows in upper part of the cardigan, and now let's start with row 6. Chain 2, turn the row, work 1 double crochet into next 8 stitches. Work 1 half double crochet into next one. Work work one single crochet into next 13 stitches, work one half double crochet into next one, finish the row with working one double crochet into next 8 stitches. As you can see here that we created two little straps, one on left and one on right side, that are 8 stitches in size, but it's exactly the same as the strap on the front upper part. But do not cut the yarn just yet, we have one more row to go, and this will be a row of half double crochet and single crochet stitches. So chain 1, turn the row, work one half double crochet into next 8 stitches, work one single crochet into next 15 stitches, you can pause the video here and come back when you finish all 15 single crochet stitches, and finish the row with one half double crochet into next 8 stitches. Cut the yarn and fasten off. If you want, you can leave a long tail for sewing, or you can also use a separate strand of yarn to sew the top of the straps together, but we will do that a little bit later. So our back upper part is now done. We still have one upper front part to go, and this one has to be a mirror shape of the one we already made. That's why we will start in the mark stitch, next to the back upper part of our cardigan. Chain 2. We will repeat what we did at the beginning of row 1 on the back upper part, We will join next two stitches with a double crochet 2 together stitch and skip the chain that we've just made in our next row. We're going double crochet into next 15 stitches. You can pause the video here and come back when you finish all 15 stitches. Let's continue with row 2, chain 2, and work 1 double crochet into next 14 stitches. You can pause the video here and come back when you finish all 14 stitches. Join the last two stitches of this row with a double crochet 2 together stitch. We are in row 3 now, chain 2 and turn the row. Work 1 double crochet stitch into each of next 15 stitches. You can pause the video here and meet me back when you finish all 15 double crochet stitches. This is now the end of row 3. Row 4 and 5 are, if you remember from the other front upper part of the cardigan, exactly the same as row 3. So turning chain is chain 2. Then you have to turn and work 1 double crochet into all 15 stitches. Please pause the video here and come back when you finish row 4 and 5. Cut the yarn and fasten off. You're in row 6. Skip first 5 stitches and join the yarn in the 6th stitch with a chain 2. Join the next 2 stitches with a double crochet 2 together stitch. Here is a small error in the video. I'm crocheting only double crochet stitch instead of double crochet 2 together. So chain 2 into the first one and then join the next 2 stitches with a double crochet 2 together instead of just double crochet stitch. Work 1 double crochet into next 7 stitches. At the end of this row, you should have 8 stitches in total. Chain 1 and turn the row. Now we are in row 7. This is a row of single crochet stitches. Then work 1 single crochet into next 8 stitches. cut the yarn and fasten off. And here is the final result, all three upper parts. Now fold your work so that the front piece will be on the top of the back one. Take a strand of yarn and start sewing the front and back strap together. It doesn't actually matter on which side of the cardigan you are sewing because both sides are more or less the same. But when you finish, turn the cardigan from the inside out so the sewing part will be in the inner side of the cardigan. What we will do now is we will take a yellow yarn and evenly work single crochet stitches all around the armholes. We will start right here with joining the yarn with a chain 1, then we will continue working single crochet stitches all the way around. We will join the round with a slip stitch and crochet it into the first stitch of this round. Now cut the yarn and hide the tails. Repeat the process for the second arm. We will start with the edging on the main part. Let's start in our right upper corner of the cardigan. Then we will continue down, then around the bottom part. Up. And we will finish in our left corner. Attach the yarn in the right upper corner with chain 1. Now work single crochet stitches evenly around the cardigan. I would recommend you to work one single crochet into the double crochet and one between two rounds of double crochet stitches. When you come to the corners, work 3 single crochet stitches into each corner to make it nice and round. After you finish, cut the yarn, fasten off, and hide all the tails. Now take a yellow yarn and chain 28. Attach the chain in the left upper corner of the cardigan and work slip stitch evenly around the neck part. When you come to the right upper corner, chain 30 and fasten up. Create two pom-poms using your fingers, wrap the yarn around your fingers and tie a knot around the middle of the pom-pom. Now it looks like a bow. Cut the yarn on both sides. Trim the pom-pom a little bit and attach it on the end of the chain. You will need two for each end one, and you are done. Thank you so much for watching, hope you learned something new. If you like this video, please give it a big thumbs up, it helps me to share this video with more people. Subscribe if you didn't already, I post new crochet videos almost every week. Have a great day and see you soon, bye!